the whole collaborative design environment really does set the stage, along with a very fast-paced approach, both for getting equipment and making decisions. And Elon makes it very clear what he wants to have accomplished. And then the teams work together, looking at the different subsystems and how do you make compromises where you need to achieve the result that Elon wants. And one of the things that really enables that is the whole incentive structure at SpaceX. And this is one of the things where we have, I think, some real challenges when you get into an established bureaucracy. Established bureaucracies tend to have certain organizations, certain silos, and the incentives for the people working in those organizations is to benefit their particular organization. And so in the mix, the overall goal of the program can get lost relative to, you know, making decisions that benefit certain parts of the organization. At SpaceX, Elon was very aware of this, and so he deliberately would not pay that high of salaries. A large part of the compensation for anyone who went to work at SpaceX was stock options. And so your real compensation comes when the company succeeds. And that does a lot to align essentially business goals and interests, that even if you're a propulsion individual, you want the TPS to succeed, because if the TPS doesn't succeed, then the company doesn't succeed, and your stock options aren't worth anything. So it creates, you know, a collaborative situation where people are pulling all towards the same goal, and they're willing to make compromises. One of the interesting things that I witnessed is that on the first Dragon capsule, the C-1, there was a problem with one of the bulkheads in the pressurized volume, that one of the bulkheads had been undersized. And the structures group actually came to the TPS group and asked if they could place a spacer to put some of the loading of that bulkhead onto the TPS structure, because we had margin in the TPS structure. And, I mean, I would never, you know, see something like that at NASA. You'd go and redo the whole bulkhead. But what they wanted to do, they wanted to get the capsule out. And they had done the analysis and said, okay, we should be okay on this capsule to transfer some of the loading, you know, from the bulkhead to the TPS support structure. And again, that, you know, allowed them to go forward. And the TPS guys took a look at it and decided, oh, yeah, it was within range. And so it was no problem. And again, so that type of collaboration of give and take on the different design, you know, challenges and solutions allows you to really move along quickly. And the other piece of it has to do with really the, again, the rapid pace of both acquiring information and system data and making decisions. And I had this one situation which has been related in several other areas, but I think it's worth noting. When I was first working with SpaceX, probably a couple months in, and this is one of the first meetings that we had to make a decision on make or buy for the heat shield, for the peak of heat shield that was going to be used on Dragon. And I was still the new kid on the block, but we had a design meeting, must have been about 10 or 11 engineers and Elon, so we had all the major subsystems represented, propulsion, TPS, structures, avionics, and then Elon. And so the group was discussing whether, you know, make or buy for this TPS material. And I was at that time just listening, because I was the new kid on the block and, okay, seeing how does this type of an organization function. And at one point, Elon looks over at me and says, well, Dan, what would you do? And so I explained to him, well, based on what I'm hearing, you know, I would actually do a make, not a buy, and here are the reasons for it. Explained that it wasn't that hard a process, and that it would allow them to optimize the peak of both for Dragon and then also have the capability for making TPS for future needs. And so after explaining this for about 3 or 4 minutes, Elon leans back. No one says anything. Elon leans back and says, that's what we're going to do. And that was the end of the meeting. And everybody stood up and left the room. And I was somewhat shell-shocked, like, what? This is the first meeting we had on this. It's, you know, we hadn't had any prep meetings. It's the first time that we were all together discussing this. And that was it. And everyone walked out the door and went to work on, okay, how do we make Pika at SpaceX? It took me several days to get over that wow, okay, did I say the right thing? You know, at NASA, we would have had, you know, many meetings looking at, okay, what are the options? You know, what are the metrics we need to be concerned with? What are the impact on other subsystems before we came to a critical decision of make or buy on a very important component?